The radio was busted, so it had been a quiet ride home until I heard a tapping on the window. I turned to see the antenna of my new car flopping all over as we cruised on down the highway. I use the term new very loosely. She was actually a 1993 gleaming red Jeep Wrangler. Quite the fixer-upper, might I add. Her name was Bessie, and she was mine. It took quite a few late nights in empty parking lots with my frustrated father to get the hang of operating a stick shift. Popping the clutch was definitely my strong point. After polishing up my first and second gear skills, my dad decided it was time to learn the hills. It was just my luck that on my first ever hill, a car pulled up behind me, and that's when I freaked out. Luckily for me and the stranger behind us, my dad offered to take the wheel. Perfect, I thought. Dad will get us out of this sticky situation. All I have to do is wave nicely to the guy behind us as I trot to the passenger side. I got this. I stepped out of the Jeep, my legs wobbly. As I reached out to close the door, my heart suddenly stopped. Bessie was rolling backwards. While my mind tried to register this information, my body froze. And that's when, out of the corner of my eye, I saw the irritated stranger speed around us. Thank goodness. I hopped back in the driver's seat as fast as possible and slammed my foot on the brake. I made the first of a long list of notes to self. Parking brake needs attention. 3 days later, I was cruising down on the highway, top down, music blaring, wearing cutoffs and a tank top, when suddenly my gas pedal lost all pressure and my forward momentum slowed to a crawl. The words my uncle muttered the day I bought Bessie rang in my ears. By the way, the fuel gauge reads a tad wrong some of the time, but y'all can get about 200 miles on a full tank. He lied. At first, I froze, having no idea what to do. After checking my surroundings, the middle of the highway, I used what momentum I had left to get Bessie to safety, radio still blaring. Eventually, I crept into the parking lot of the Pentecostal church. Before I knew it, all eyes were on me. I'm sure they were thinking, boy, does she need the Lord. However, shortly thereafter, things started taking a turn for the better. Bessie and I were trudging up a hill as I was giving her a pep talk. Come on, Bessie, you can make it, darling. I punched the clutch and attempted to gear down when all I heard was the sound of a dying animal. I was stuck in neutral on a hill. I was done for. I inched onto the nearest street and pulled over. Soon enough, someone had come to my rescue, but not just any someone. I looked into those breathtaking blue eyes and could hardly comprehend the, "Do you need any help with that?" coming out of this angel's mouth. Stuttering, I came up with the response, hi. I knew my cheeks were redder than Bessie herself. Then came the day that I was leaving school and Bessie made it about 30 feet before she decided to act up. The love of my life was right behind me, and I was beyond embarrassed when the moment came to wave him around my car. To my surprise, he stopped and asked if I needed a ride. Although I could have easily fixed the problem and headed home in a matter of minutes, why pass up the opportunity for true love? Winter came sooner than I would have liked, top and doors on. It was my first cruise around town with Bessie all suited up when I cheated a yellow light. I knew I shouldn't have done it, but things had been going so well, and I am a teenager after all. I whipped around the corner, and that's when it hit me. Karma. A gush of wind poured into my car to remind me that I had forgotten to attach a few things, like my door. It swung so wide that the bottom of the door stuck in my front tire, creating a nice burnt rubber aroma. Luckily for me, I didn't panic like I had just a few short months before on the hill, but instead I kept my cool and stayed on the road. The door swung wide again, and this time towards me, and I was able to grab it and latch it enough to get to the next parking lot and reattach it securely. Lesson learned again. As I glided back onto the road and turned up the radio, I realized that Bessie may be stressful, unreliable, and a bit of a pain, but she has her perks. All she ever needed was a little tender love and care. I sat back in the seat, shifted into third, and smiled.